I'm so grateful for this journey that the Navy has taken me on. Both when I was active duty and now in the reserves. And I can step back and look at all these photos that I've taken and relive what has been an amazing career and adventure. Some of my earliest memories is being in my mother's dark room and just the smell of the chemicals and her creating an image. And that is when I truly fell in love with photography. You could create something out of nothing. After high school, I applied to go to the Pittsburgh Art Institute. I got accepted, but there was just no way I could afford it. So then I started working at this small local gas station. I love the people because it's a small town. You know the people who come in. But I knew I wanted to do more to my life than just work at a gas station. How can I be a photographer? How can I pursue this career field? That is when I'm just like, you know what? I need to do something different. I'm joining the military. I went to the Navy recruiting station. He said, okay, we have good news and we have bad news. Photography opened up. There's a spot. The bad news is you leave in 2 weeks. I said, put me on the bus. I am 100% on board. I am a mass communication specialist, also known as an MC. Our job is we tell the story of the Navy. We take photos, we do video, we write stories. We also document it for historical archives. When you look at the footage from D-Day, a military photographer took those images. So that's what we're doing, is we're preserving these moments that may seem mundane now, but in the future, you never know what the significance is gonna be. Not every shoot that you go on is going to be glamorous, action-packed. It's those jobs that don't seem like they would be historically significant that you truly find those moments that really separate what people think the Navy is and what it actually is. We're not just all big guns and big ships. We're people. And it's really important to show that that's who we are. But it's also important for the people I take the photos of.
There we go, perfect. 1, 2, 3.
They might be the best mechanic, but you could never know. What we do is we capture their hard work and we get to share it.
Oh, there we go. That's what I'm talking about. Gorgeous.
By showing the human side of the Navy, you're showing the real side of the Navy. And that's why I believe it's so important to capture every moment that you can as honestly as you can, and then share that. So after 8 years of being in the Navy, I found my husband, and I didn't want to be stationed away from him. But I really love the Navy, and I didn't want to get out 100%. So instead of cutting ties entirely with the Navy, I transitioned to the reserves. Knowing that the reserves were there for me, I could still be a part of something that I love, but also I can start the second life as a public affairs officer of the Forest Service. I have this amazing career in the Navy that I still get to go on deployment, that I still get to feel like I'm a part of a team. But when I'm not serving my country in that capacity, I get to serve my country as a member of the Forest Service. When you look at being a part of the military and you look at being a civilian, at first you think they're two different worlds, but they're not. People are people. People are genuine, people are caring, people are loving. I love hearing their stories.
One, two.
And I really love experiencing something from somebody else's perspective. Everybody has a story worth telling. The trick is finding it. Being able to take pictures of someone to show them what they do and their contribution to either the Navy or society is amazing. I get the chance and the opportunity to show people their true worth, even if they don't always see it themselves. I'm Kathleen Gorby, and I'm a mass communications specialist for the United States Navy Reserves.